Hi, I'm Masha with TechNexion. In today's tutorial, we show you how to work with the TechNexion software loader. When you purchase a product from TechNexion, such as an evaluation kit, our software loader is pre-installed on the product. After you unpack the product and assemble the module on a baseboard and the baseboard to a display, you power up the unit, you will see the TechNexion software loader. Today, I'm going to show you how to work with the TechNexion software loader and how to install an image onto your TechNexion product using the software loader. What you will need is a network cable that you connect to the network interface. This network cable is connected to a switch or an access point in your office or your home, and have to provide by DHCP an IP address to the unit. Also, you will need internet access. You will see that in a bit. You also need to provide power to the unit, which I do currently. The PicoPi IMX8M Mini that is here on display is using a USB Type-C power to provide power to the unit. The unit is currently booting up. You already saw a TechNexion splash screen logo. In the background, the software loader is booting up, connecting to our servers to check what images are available on the unit. It will show you exactly what it is doing, and if it's failing, it gives you a message what you need to correct. For example, you didn't connect the network cable, you don't have internet access. If you do have any problems and you need to get in touch with us, always let us know the TSL, TechNexion Software Loader version that you are running on the unit. You can see it in the right top corner. The one in this movie is 20.09. Let us know this so we can help you. Okay, the first screen, an overview. You will be presented with the operation system options available for your development kit. For the Pico IMX 8M Mini, as of today, we have Ubuntu, Yocto, Butuh-Qt, and Android version 9 available for the kit. So for this tutorial, let's install Qt. So I select Qt. Okay. The baseboard and the display are auto-detected on boot up. So you will see now you want to install Butuh-Qt on a Pi baseboard with a 5-inch display. If you want to change the baseboard to another baseboard, you can do so. You can change from a Pi to a Wizard, for example, or another baseboard. Let's keep with the Pi. On the Pi, we only have a 5-inch display option, so that is currently the only one that is available. Okay, once you are happy with your selection, click here on the right to finalize your selection. It will connect to the TechNexion cloud and download the image and install this onto the unit. Say clearly here, do not power off the device because currently we are installing an image. If you want to stop this process, there is an abort button here. And if you press the abort button, it will ask you, do you want to really abort, yes or no? Currently we do no. If you do yes, it will recondition the TechNexion software loader on it, and you need to power cycle the unit and you are on the first screen again. So, but for this tutorial today, we complete the installation of the unit. It might take a couple minutes to do that, depending on your location and how many people are working with the software loader at the time that you are working with it. Take about, I estimate, 5 to 10 minutes in normal situations. If you're unlucky, it might take you like a 15 to 20 minutes. It's fully automated, so you can go to get a coffee if it takes a lot of time. And so, okay, this is installed. Now it is making sure that it is installed. And now it says, congratulations, installation complete. Please power cycle the unit. So we can do that by removing the power. And then, of course, we want to see what we did. And so I apply the power again. and the unit is now booting up. You see the penguins that we didn't see in the tutorial loader. Loading Qt Launcher, and there we are. Okay. So that is it for today's tutorial. You now know how to work with the TechNexion software loader. We hope you enjoyed this. Subscribe to our channel and see you soon again. Thank you.